This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Metrolink, also known as Manchester Metrolink, is a light rail tram system in Greater Manchester, England. The system is owned by Transport for Greater Manchester TFGM and operated and maintained under contract by RATP Group in 2015-16. 343 million passenger journeys were made on the system. The network consists of 7 lines which radiate from Manchester city centre to termini at Altrincham, Ashton-under-Lyne, Bury, East Didsbury, Eccles, Manchester Airport and Rochdale. Metrolink has 93 stops along 57 miles 92. Creation expansion of Metrolink has been a key strategy of transport planners in Greater Manchester, who have overseen its development in successive projects, known as Phases 1, 2, 3A, 3B and 2CC. A second line through Manchester city centre to eliminate the current bottleneck will be operational by the end of 2016, and work on the Trafford Park line extension from Pomona to the Trafford Centre is expected to commence in 2016 with an estimated operational date of 2020-2021. Furthermore, TFGM have endorsed more speculative expansion proposals for new lines to Stockport, a loop around Wythenshowe, and the addition of tram train technology. Contents 1 History 11 Predecessors 12 Origins 13 Phase 1 Bury, Altrincham and Manchester City Centre 14 Phase 2, Salford Quays, Eccles 15 Phase 3151 Phase 3A, Oldham, Rochdale, East Manchester Line 152 Phase 3B, Ashton-under-Lyne, East Didsbury and Manchester Airport 16 Phase 2CC 17 Trafford Park Extension 2, Operator 21 Branding and Public Relations 3 Infrastructure 31 Stops and Lines 32 Depots 33 Wi-Fi 34 Proposed Changes and Expansion 341 Buckley Wells 342 Middleton Extension 343 Oldham Extension 344 Salford Expansion 345 Stalybridge Extension 346 Stockport Tram Train Strategy 347 Trafford Park Line 348 Tram Trains 349 Wythenshowe Loop 4, Rolling Stock 41 M5042 Ancillary Vehicles 43 Former Fleet 431 T68, 68A5 Incidents 6 Travelling 61 Service and Hours of Operation 62 Ticketing 7 Tram Services 8 Passenger Numbers 9 See also 10 Notes 11 References 111 Bibliography 12 External Links History Main articles, History of Manchester Metrolink and Timeline of Manchester Metrolink Predecessors. Manchester's first tram age had begun in 1877 with the first horse trams of Manchester Suburban Tramways Company and ceased as early as in 1949, when the last line of the Municipal Manchester Corporation Tramways was displaced by motor buses. That company had managed most of the electrification of the trams, executed 1901-1903. Since 1938, some trams had been displaced by trolleybuses. Electric traction on tyres in the streets of Manchester ended in 1966. Origins see also, Pick Vic Tunnel. A light rail system for Greater Manchester was born of the failure to obtain central government funding for the Pick Vic scheme linking the existing railway systems north and south of the city centre via a tunnel. Greater Manchester's railway network suffered from poor north-south connections, relying on bus connections through the city centre by means of the Centrelink bus service. Piccadilly and Victoria were built in the 1840s by rival companies on cheaper land on the fringes of the city centre as early as 1839. In anticipation of the stations being built, a connecting underground railway tunnel was proposed but abandoned on economic grounds, as was an overground suspended monorail in 1966 SELNEC passenger. Transport Executive, the body tasked with improving public transport for Manchester and its surrounding municipalities in the 1960s, made draft proposals for a Pick Vic Tunnel, a proposed rail route beneath the city centre, forming the centrepiece of a new electrified railway network for the region. Despite investigatory tunnelling under the Manchester Arndale Shopping Centre, when the Greater Manchester County Council presented the project to the United Kingdom government in 1974, it was unable to secure the necessary funding, and was abandoned on economic grounds when the county council dropped the plans in 1977. In 1982, the Greater Manchester Passenger Transport Executive GMPTE, the successor to SELNEC Private, concluded that a street-level light rail system to replace or complement the region's underused heavy railways was the cheapest solution to improving Greater Manchester's rail transport network. A rail study group, composed of officials from British Rail, Greater Manchester County Council and GMPTE, formally endorsed the scheme in 1984. Abstract proposals based on light rail systems in North America and continental Europe, and a draft 62-mile 100. The system be constructed in phases. Additional taxpayer funding came from the European Regional Development Fund and bank lending. Phase 1: Bury, Altrincham and Manchester City Centre main articles, Bury Line and Altrincham Line, conversion of the East Lancashire Railway, Bury to Victoria and Manchester, South Junction and Altrincham Railway, Altrincham to Piccadilly heavy rail lines, and creation of a street-level tramway through Manchester City Centre to unite the lines as a single 192-mile 309. Transport on 24 October 1989, and formally signed on 6 June 1990. The Bury Line was closed in stages between 13 July 1991 and 17 August 1991, after which the 1,200 volts DC third rail electrified line was adapted for a 750 volts DC overhead line operation in Manchester City Centre. A tramway, built with network expansion in mind, from Victoria to Piccadilly via Market Street and Piccadilly Gardens, connected Bury to Altrincham via Manchester. The overhead structures and wiring of the Altrincham line were adapted for light rail, as well as upgrades to signalling and stations on the network. A combined headquarters, depot and control centre was built at Cheetham Hill on Queen's Road, north of Victoria Station, at a cost of £8 million, £15,500,000 pounds as of 2016. 2 T68 trams near Manchester Piccadilly Station in 1994. This was part of the original system, opened as part of Phase 1, initially projected to open in September 1991, then promised for 21 February 1992. Metrolink began operation on 6 April 1992 with a service between Victoria and Bury, along with the Tyne and Wear Metro and Docklands Light Railway. It helped to reintroduce light rail to the United Kingdom. The network was expanded beyond Victoria to G-Mex tram stop on 27 April 1992. A service through to Altrincham joined the network on 15 June 1992, completing Phase 1 and enabling use of all 26 T68 vehicles acquired for the operation. Queen Elizabeth II declared Metrolink open at a ceremony in Manchester on 17 July 1992, adding that Metrolink would improve communication between northern and southern Greater Manchester. After the ceremony, the Queen visited Manchester Town Hall and rode from St. Peter's Square to Bury to visit Bury Town Hall, then costing £145 million, £270,600,000 pounds as of 2016. Phase 1 was expected to carry 10 million passengers per year, but surpassed this figure by the 1993-94 fiscal year, and every year thereafter, in recognition of passenger demands and the decommissioning of the Arndale bus station after the 1996 Manchester bombing. Adjustments were made to Phase 1 to the design of Manchester City Council's City Centre Masterplan, by modifying Market Street tram stop to handle two-way traffic, demolishing High Street tram stop in 1998 and creating a new stop for Shudehill Interchange in 2002. Sections of track in the city centre were relaid following damage to the road surface adjacent to the line by 2003. Phase 1 was deemed a long-term success by GMPTE, and, with overcrowding at peak times, carried more than 15 million passengers per year. Phase 2, Salford Quays, Eccles main article, Eccles Line. Metrolink after Phase 2 1999-2000 extension of the Metrolink network was intended to be continuous, with successive expansion phases delivered in strict order of priority. GMPTE wanted to repeat its success with Phase 1 by converting other parts of Greater Manchester's underutilized suburban rail network. However, changes in circumstances and new opportunities, combined with a shift in government policy following the early 1990s recession, stalled the immediate expansion of Metrolink after Phase 1. Phase 1A, a proposed east-west route from Eastlands to Dumplington via Salford Quays, was muted by uncertainty surrounding the Manchester bid for the 2000 Summer Olympics, the unbuilt Trafford Centre, and regeneration of Manchester docks respectively. Nevertheless, throughout the 1990s, the Greater Manchester Passenger Transport Authority continued to acquire rights to construct Metrolink lines under the Transport and Works Act 1992. AT68A vehicle, street running in Eccles, specially acquired for the new Eccles line, opened in 1999 as part of Phase 2. During the 1990s, Salford Quays became a business district specifically redeveloped for commerce, leisure, culture and tourism, with a high density of business units and modern housing, complemented by a cinema complex, office blocks, and waterfront promenade. As it had poor public transport integration and no rail provision, it was earmarked for a potential Metrolink line as early as 1986, and legal authority to construct the line through the Quays was acquired in 1990. The Quays received millions of pounds of investment, and a public consultation and public inquiry resulted in government endorsement in 1994. In autumn 1995, a 4-mile 64 slow and meandering route, and failed to reach its initial passenger targets. Patronage increased during the 2000s as the Eccles line steadily increased in popularity, in keeping with a rise in passenger numbers across the whole Metrolink system, and was beginning to become overcrowded by the end of the decade. Phase 3 main articles, Airport Line, Manchester Metrolink, East Manchester Line, Oldham and Rochdale Line, and South Manchester Line. In 2000, officials and transport planners in Greater Manchester considered Metrolink to be a phenomenal success. The system was exceeding patronage targets and reducing traffic congestion on roads running parallel to its lines. Consequently, when the Transport Act 2000 required passenger transport executives to produce local transport plans, GMPTE's top public transport priority was a third phase of Metrolink expansion, which would create four new lines along key transport corridors in Greater Manchester: the Oldham and Rochdale line routed northeast to Oldham and Rochdale, the East Manchester line routed east to East Manchester and Ashton-under-Lyne, the South Manchester line routed southeast to Corlton Cum Hardy and East Didsbury, and the Airport line routed south to Wythenshowe and Manchester Airport. The East Manchester line would capitalize on serving the city of Manchester Stadium, a host venue of the 2002 Commonwealth Games. Satisfied it would deliver a key policy commitment with faster expansion and greater value from economies of scale, GMPTE and the Association of Greater Manchester Authorities AGMA lobbied central government to provide partial funding to upgrade the current network with a new depot, passenger information displays, and construct four new lines in a single Phase 3 contract dubbed the Big Bang, worth £489 million, £742,300,000 as of 2016. Spur to MediaCityk opened 2010, conceding that it would be very difficult to bring Metrolink to the city of Manchester Stadium by 2002. The government accepted its importance to Greater Manchester and the Commonwealth Games on the 22nd of March 2000, with an announcement from Deputy Prime Minister John Prescott that a £289 million government contribution to fund Phase 3 would make Metrolink the envy of Europe. The remaining £200 million was assembled from the private sector by July 2000. Following the announcement, preparatory work such as legal costs, land acquisition and construction of rail bridges over the River Medlock was actioned. However, Metrolink made a loss in 2002 and failed to reduce traffic congestion in Manchester city centre. Costs for Phase 3 implementation were revised in the December after the 2002 Commonwealth Games, totalling £820 million, £1,203 million as of 2016, meaning Metrolink required a government contribution of at least £520 million, with costs predicted to rise further, and concerns raised over light rail procurement nationally. On 20 July 2004, Alistair Darling, the Secretary of State for Transport, announced the government had withdrawn its share of funding Metrolink due to excessive costs in response, highlighting the legal costs and demolition of homes, schools and offices in anticipation of the new lines. The Get Our Metrolink Back on Track or Back on Track campaign, spearheaded by the Manchester Evening News and members of Parliament from Greater Manchester, was organised to lobby the Department for Transport to fund Phase 3. On 16 December 2004, Alistair Darling announced that the government would fund Phase 3 but not at any price, capping its investment for Metrolink enhancements at £520 million. An initial £102 million funding package was granted by the government in July 2005 for Phase 3 preparatory work, and a Carillion-led track renewal program for 12 miles 19. spur off the Eccles Line to the new Mediacityic development at Salford Quays, funded separately by the Northwest Regional Development Agency NWRDA, would also fall to M-PACT Thales Phase 3A, Oldham, Rochdale, East Manchester Line Metrolink after Phase 3A 2009-13 Phase 3A, dubbed the Mini Bang, or Little Bang, was an extension scheme approved by the government on 6 July 2006, with final sign-off and release of Treasury funds in May 2008 in addition to the separately NWRDA-funded spur from the Eccles Line to Mediacityic. Phase 3A involved converting the 14-mile 23. Preparatory work on Central Park tram stop and a flyover at Newton Heath over the heavy Caldervale line commenced in 2005. Conversion of the Oldham Loop for Metrolink allowed for the addition of new stops along the line, including Monsall, South Chatterton, and Newbold. Kingsway Business Park tram stop was authorized at a late stage of planning in July 2011 once the Phase 3B Drake Street tram stop was abandoned on technical and economic grounds and additional funding was procured from Rochdale Metropolitan Borough Council and Kingsway Business Park's private developer Wilson Bowden Shaw and Crompton tram stop on its opening day of 16 December 2012. The planned opening of Phase 3A services was initially delayed on each line by months due to faults with a new £22 million digital signalling and control system known as the Tram Management System, or TMS, designed by the Thales Group. Services on the spur from the Eccles Line to Mediacityic tram stop were expected to commence during summer 2010, and began on the 20th of September 2010, serving Mediacityic, a 200-acre 81. Expected to commence in spring 2011, but delayed until 7 July 2011, due to problems with TMS on the Oldham and Rochdale line. Services from Manchester to Central Park and Oldham Mumps were expected to open in spring 2011 and autumn 2011 respectively, but problems with TMS and the need to renew structures delayed services until 13 June 2012, when 71 miles 114. Passenger services expanded along the 46-mile 74. Reroute and extend the Oldham and Rochdale line at a cost of £124,500,000 with a street running route through Oldham and Rochdale town centres, both of which were poorly served by using the outlying Oldham Mumps and Rochdale railway stations alone. Tasked with procuring funds for Phase 3B from sources other than central government, in July 2007 GMPTE and AGMA submitted a bid to the Transport Innovation Fund, which would release a multi-million pound sum for public transport improvements linked to viable anti-road traffic congestion strategies. A referendum on the Greater Manchester Transport Innovation Fund was held in Greater Manchester on 19 December 2008, in which 79% of voters rejected plans for public transport improvements linked to a peak time weekday only Greater Manchester congestion charge. In May 2009, Greater Manchester Integrated Transport Authority, formerly GMPTA and AGMA, agreed to create the Greater Manchester Transport Fund, £15 billion raised from a combination of a levy on council tax in Greater Manchester, government grants, contributions from the Manchester Airports Group, Metrolink fares and third-party funding for major transport schemes in the region. Phase 3B was approved with funding on a line-by-line basis between March and August 2010. A tram passing over a purpose-built viaduct over the River Mersey on the newly opened airport line. In November 2014, construction work for all Phase 3B lines began in March 2011 on the airport line. A 580-ton steel bridge was erected in Wythenshawe over the M56 motorway on 25 November 2012 following the closure of Mosley Street tram stop on 17 May 2013, the 27-mile 43. The second city crossing, also known as 2CC, is a second Metrolink route across Manchester city centre, first proposed in 2011 as a means to improve capacity, flexibility and reliability as the rest of the system expands due to phases 3A and 3B funded by the Greater Manchester Transport Fund, its 08 mile 13. See also, Transport for Greater Manchester and RATP Group. Metrolink stops are marked with yellow totems, such as this one at Mediacityic. Metrolink is owned by TFGM and operated and maintained by private transport firms under an operating and maintenance O. Manchester. Metrolink ran a nickname Metrolink competition to find an affectionate short name for the system, comparable to the Tube for London Underground and the L for the Chicago Elevated Transit System. Most submissions were inspired by textile manufacturing, Greater Manchester's historic staple industry, using names such as the Thread and the Shuttle, but the winning entry was the Met. In 2008, a distinctive yellow and metallic silver vehicle livery, and corresponding yellow system-wide corporate rebranding was introduced by Manchester-based Hemisphere Design and Marketing Consultancy, designed in partnership with Peter Saville, Dalton Mogg, and Design Triangle. Yellow was chosen by Hemisphere for its high visibility and to reflect Greater Manchester's culture of confidence and optimism. Metrolink has been a football development partner with the Manchester Football Association since August 2010, meaning it is the association's official travel partner, and supports grassroots association football in Greater Manchester by selecting a Team of the Month. Metrolink is a sponsor of the annual Manchester Food and Drink Festival on 6 December 2010, to celebrate the soap opera's 50th anniversary. Coronation Street featured a storyline with an explosion which caused a crash on the Metrolink system at Weatherfield, although a fictitious event. At least 6 calls were made to GMPTE asking if services had been affected. Transport planners in Greater Manchester describe Metrolink as both an icon of Greater Manchester, and an integral part of the landscape in Greater Manchester. The Guardian describes Metrolink as Manchester's efficient and much-loved tram system. Under ownership of the Guardian Media Group, the Manchester Evening News spearheaded the Get Our Metrolink Back on Track campaign in 2004-05 under Trinity Mirror ownership. The Manchester Evening News used the Freedom of Information Act 2000 to reveal that Metrolink received over 10,000 complaints between May 2011 and May 2012 in 2013. Then Manchester City FC manager Roberto Mancini and players Joe Hart, Vincent Kompany and James Milner recorded special stop announcements to be used on Metrolink's East Manchester line on dates when Manchester City play at home at the City of Manchester Stadium served by the Etihad Campus tram stop. The announcements were first used on 17 February 2013, for Manchester City's FA Cup 5th round tie against Leeds United AFC. Infrastructure stops and lines, passenger information displays PIDs at St. Peter's Square as of December 2015. Metrolink has a network length of 57 miles 92. Altrincham, the Bury line which terminates in Bury, the East Manchester line which terminates in Ashton-under-Lyne, the South Manchester line which terminates in East Didsbury, the Eccles line which terminates in Eccles, and the Oldham and Rochdale line which terminates in Rochdale. Some stops, such as Cornbrook, are shared between lines, and may be used as interchange stations. Others, such as Altrincham Interchange, are transport hubs which integrate with heavy rail and bus stations. Each stop has at least one high-floor platform measuring a minimum of 2.66 meters. First light rail network in the UK with electricity supplied entirely from sustainable energy via hydropower. Now, energy for the system is generated by biomass. Metrolink lines and zones. Line or zone first operated route types. Length, number of stations. Peak frequency. Start terminus. Current airport line 3 November 2014 on and off street 232. 145. 159. 60. Off street 03. 7 July 2011 converted railway bed 71. And runs over the floodplain alongside Rifle Road. Carrot follows the Eccles line routes from Piccadilly before turning off at Harbour City to Media City. Carrot Transport and Works Act 1992. Powers granted October 2016. Construction is planned to begin in 2016 with funding from the rebate package as part of the city deal. The line is planned to be completed by 2019-20. Depot's Metrolink House at Queen's Road in Cheetham Hill is the headquarters of Metrolink, constructed during Phase 1. It served jointly as a control center, HQ, office space, and depot for the storage, maintenance and repair of vehicles. Under the original proposals, Metrolink House was much larger, with a design which would support network expansion, but this design did not obtain the necessary planning permission from Manchester City Council. Consequently, Metrolink House was scaled down to a 4-hectare 99-acre £8 million site with limited capacity, and, in light of Phase 3A network expansion, Metrolink built a second depot at Elsinore Road in Old Trafford. In 2011, this second depot occupies the site of a former warehouse, and can house up to 96 vehicles. On 7 May 2013, Metrolink completed the transfer of its main operational functions from Cheetham Hill to Old Trafford, meaning its control room, known as the Network Management Center, is housed jointly with The customer services team by its newer depot Wi-Fi in July 2013, the Transport for Greater Manchester Committee announced that it planned to enhance the experience of travelling on Metrolink by tapping into Manchester City Council's grant from the UK Urban Broadband Fund and using it to provide Metrolink passengers with free Wi-Fi when on board. The scheme began with a trial on a single tram, number 3054, connected to the FreeBeamCR broadband network, with the intention of rolling it out across the whole Metrolink network by spring 2015. It was rolled out fleet-wide in March 2015. Proposed changes and expansion. Buckley Wells tram stop has been proposed to provide better passenger access in southern Bury, and would be on the Bury line between Bury Interchange and Radcliffe tram stop Middleton Extension as of 2013. Rochdale Metropolitan Borough Council aspires to link Middleton to the Metrolink network by constructing a branch off the Bury line routed from Boker Vale tram stop to Middleton Town Centre. Rochdale Council first proposed this extension of Metrolink to Middleton in 2008, and priced the scheme at £80 million. Oldham Extension. In January 2016, Jim McMahon, MP for Oldham West and Royton, proposed two loop extensions to the Metrolink system around Oldham. The link would add a spur from Westwood tram stop to Middleton Town Centre, before joining the Bury line near Boker Vale. In line with the proposed Middleton extension, the Ashton Loop would extend the line beyond Ashton Town Centre to Oldham Mumps. Both would connect Rochdale to its neighbouring towns without the need to travel in and out of Manchester City Centre. Initial high-level feasibility work was undertaken by officials at Transport for Greater Manchester, which demonstrated the route as technically possible. Salford expansion. In Salford City Council's 2004-2016 Unitary Development Plan, extending from Eccles Interchange along the A57 road to Barton-upon-Irwell and then across the Manchester Ship Canal to the Trafford Centre, reopening the Tyldesley loopline from Eccles to Little Houlton via Walkden with Metrolink services tram train between Manchester and Wigan via Salford, as proposed by the Regional Spatial Strategy for North West England. Stalybridge Extension. As of 2011, Tameside Metropolitan Borough Council aspires to extend the East Manchester line from Ashton under Lyne to Stalybridge. Stockport tram train strategy. In January 2015, Stockport Metropolitan Borough adopted a rail strategy proposing substantial conversion of current rail alignments around Stockport to tram train operation, running into an interchange at Stockport bus station. These proposed services expand on, and are consistent with, those outlined in the TFGM tram train strategy document. Earlier plans, now discarded, had envisaged the Metrolink line to East Didsbury being extended to Stockport along the Mersey Valley. The revised plan proposes instead a revised alignment for this link via Edgeley and Stockport Railway Station. Stockport Town Centre to Manchester City Centre via Heaton Norris, Reddish South and Bellevue, linking with the proposed Manchester Marple tram train line. Stockport Town Centre to Manchester Airport via Edgeley and Bagley. Stockport Town Centre to Altrincham via Edgeley and Bagley. Stockport Town Centre to East Didsbury and on to Manchester City Centre, via Edgeley and Gorsey Bank. Hazel Grove to East Didsbury via Gorsey Bank. In the rail strategy, Stockport MBC also outline longer-term aspirations to establish tram train services between Stockport Town Centre and Marple, and between Stockport Town Centre and Ashton Town Centre. Trafford Park Line. Main article, Trafford Park Line. TFGM holds powers to commission a new line from Pomona to Port Salford via Trafford Park and the Trafford Centre, and committed to procuring a funding mechanism for its construction in 2011, drawing on proposals made by Trafford Metropolitan Borough Council in 1984. TFGM made this a strategic priority in each of its local transport plans since the Transport Act 2000, attesting that Metrolink provision will improve public access to key attractions, support the development of business and freight zones, and reduce traffic congestion on the M60 motorway. In 2004, Peel Holdings raised concerns that the lack of Metrolink provision to the Trafford Centre may impact on its chill factor development, and offered to contribute towards its cost. In summer 2013, the Greater Manchester Combined Authority and the Greater Manchester Local Enterprise Partnership announced it may fund the construction of the line as far as a stop at the Trafford Centre using the earn-back mechanism of the Greater Manchester City deal, with an extension to Port Salford and Eccles to be developed and costed separately. TFGM estimated that it would require £350 million to open this route to passengers by its target of 2018-19, subject to a satisfactory business case. Transport and Works Act order and public consultation in November 2014, the UK Treasury confirmed earn-back funding for the Trafford Park line as part of the devolution deal for the Greater Manchester Combined Authority Tram Trains Metrolink, and the TFGM committee have prepared 5 costed proposals for extending Metrolink using tram train technology over the existing heavy rail network in the region, along the Mid-Cheshire line between Stockport and Hale, the Hope Valley line between Manchester and Marple, the Glossop line between Manchester and the dual termini at Hadfield and Glossop, the Manchester to Sheffield line between Manchester and Hazel Grove, and along the Manchester to Southport line between Manchester and Wigan via Atherton, with an estimated total funding requirement of £870 million as of 2013. TFGM intend to proceed to the identification of potential rail industry funding options, subject to a review of lessons from a tram train pilot scheme in Sheffield Wythenshawe Loop, although axed in 2005 to control costs. The Wythenshawe Loop on the Airport Line remains an aspiration of TFGM. As of October 2014, there is renewed interest from TFGM, particularly as the route could link with HS2 Manchester Interchange. It would create a loop from Roundthorne Tram Stop to the University Hospital of South Manchester Wythenshawe Hospital and Newall Green and back to Roundthorne, and improve access between Wythenshawe and Manchester city centre on a route which is physically impaired by the River Mersey and M60 motorway rolling stock. Metrolink is operated by fleet of M5000 trams, the number of which reached 120 by October 2016. The first M5000 trams were introduced in 2009, and replaced the former fleet of 32 T68 and T68A trams, which had operated the network since opening in 1992. These were withdrawn from service during 2012-14 in order to be compatible with the former heavy rail stations Metrolink inherited. The network uses high-floor trams with a platform height of 900. Increased successively to 94 in December 2013, a further 10 M5000s were ordered to provide trams for the Trafford Park line planned to open in 2020, while in the interim supporting a service between Mediacityk and Manchester city centre and other capacity enhancements. In September 2014, a further 16 were ordered. This will bring the fleet up to 120.